Hello my friends, welcome to another AI for Architecture tutorial. Today we'll quickly cover Fooocus, which is an alternative to Automatic 1111. My name's Matt. If you Google Fooocus with three O's, you'll see this pop up. And I noticed that Olivio Sarakis popped in as a recommendation in my video, so take that chance to say definitely check him out for AI generated tips and tricks. It's a great channel, taught me a lot. Thank you, Olivio. We're going to go to the main GitHub page here for Fooocus. And if you scroll down and install this version, it's great, but a recommendation from Jens Anderson on my Facebook page, he suggested that I check out the fork, which is a separate offshoot of this repository. And this guy, Moonride303, has created a better version, in my opinion. He's improved on it, a couple features that like control net that we have to use in architecture. So scroll down, go to download Windows, and you're going to have a 7z file, which is a compressed zip file. Can't open it, just download the free version of WinRAR, WINRAR. Download that, extract it, put it into a directory. I keep all of my stable diffusion engines here under my C drive. And so I have labeled this SD Fooocus MRE. Go into the separate directory here. And if you need to, you want to edit the paths. In this case, for Fooocus, you go to your paths example.json file, rename that to paths.json, edit this with a text editor. In my case, I have Visual Studio installed, but you can just use Notepad. Go in here and change these directories to where you can find each type of LoRa, embedding, control net, etc. You'll notice the slash is the opposite direction. So be mindful of that. These go opposite to what you're normally used to in Windows. So save that, close it. That's only if you need to have access to your other checkpoints. So paths. .json. I'm going to go back to the root and run the mre.bat file. The first thing you'll notice when you start Fooocus MRE in your browser is how simple it is. The designer wanted to have this Midjourney experience where it was really nothing more than a simple prompt, and you can get results right away by having a simple prompt, something like a modern house in a forest next to a lake with fog. And I'm going to put fog again in brackets. The more brackets you have, the more emphasis it is on that. And then I'm going to add photo and detail. We'll generate, and the default is to generate two images at once. So you'll see that once we open the advanced tabs. We can reduce this number down to one, and I'm going to do that for the testing. And it's the additional prompt feature of Fooocus is this prompt expansion, Fooocus version 2. And that is evident when you go to your backend. You can see that it's adding suffixes. And I haven't figured out how it's figuring out what to add. In this tape, it's extremely detailed octane render, 8K. When I'm rendering something, I don't particularly want it to look like a render, so I'm going for photorealism, and I'm not sure that's something that we particularly want in our prompting. So you can uncheck that and get similar results. I mean, generally right out the gate, these look pretty good, and we can generate again. I'll reduce this to one image and show you the results without the prompt expansion. It doesn't change speed at all. These are typical prompts, especially when we started using Stable Diffusion earlier this year. The addition of these prompts were something people were experimenting with that made a big difference, but I don't really see that it adds much value now. So we'll start with this image. Looks pretty cool. Okay, just for curiosity, I ran the speed, performance, and then custom. And as you can see, they're all the exact same, and it's not the compression on the MPEG video that we're viewing on YouTube. There is absolutely no difference. The only way to get any performance difference would be to use custom and increase the steps. And then we have the switch to refiner also through some testing, the refiner does almost nothing now with these improved models. I'm using the base model. I believe that you might, depending on when you're watching this video, you may have the realistic stock photo as the default, which is fantastic, so leave that as is. If not, you can go down to Civit AI, download it, put it in the directory where the model checkpoints are. We can leave all this the same, that's fine. For the demonstration, I'll keep this at 40, keep the resolution the same. We have our different styles that we can add to our image here. This is also a prompt expansion. And so if we type in photo, and I can do something like long exposure, and I'll add in nothing. I'll do photo long exposure, and we have the fixed seed, and that way we can see each result from the image styles and what kind of change they're bringing to our generated image. Okay, so that's what the long exposure did. That is essentially adding additional prompt. That's the idea there. Then we have the LoRAs. You can add in your own LoRAs, which are basically like an add-on to the base stable diffusion model that you're using here. And in this case, this is a contrast and detail sampler. You can experiment with these values up to 2. Next, we have our sampling. CFG is how closely the image generator sticks to the prompts. Higher the value, the more rigid the encoder is to these words, these prompts. The lower the value, the more flexibility it has with your prompts. I haven't really figured out what base skip and refiner skip does. The examples on the documentation really don't make it clear, so I would just leave those as blank. Your sampler can be, the good default is the SD++. Keep that as default for your architecture. All right, the next big thing besides the sampler, these will give subtle variations. However, the scheduler between Keras and Exponential will give you completely different results. And I really wouldn't be able to explain the difference between them. It's just a matter of trying and experimenting. This is the Keras, for example, and this is the Exponential sampler. Within sampler, next we have Free U. It's a really interesting add-on that they've included in this version of Fooocus. It is a separate paper and can't understand at all how it works. However, through the experimentation, if you increase these numbers a little bit up to, let's say we'll just do 0.2, 1.2, you will get, there's a little more drama and a little bit of interesting color that seems to be added on. It's almost like you're passing it through some type of filter in Photoshop. It's the best way I could explain it. You just have a little more drama in the scene. I'd say that it alters the image, but it also has this incredible level of almost HDRI effect. So you can play with that down here. The next thing that's important, of course, is our control nets, and they're only important if you're going to be using an existing image. And in this case, we're going to take an old rendering, we're going to modify it in Stable Diffusion, and here we load a image that doesn't have any fog of a, let's say we'll use this, we're going to use this 1K image. This is a raw rendering, and since I already have the prompts that say fog in brackets, purposes of visualization, I'm going to do 0.5, which I would interpret as 50% of your prompts and 50% of the base image. They go together and it creates this noise matrix that they have in called a latent space, and then it's brought back and regenerated. Of course, right now I didn't turn it on, so you have to not only use it in the tab, but you have to have image to image clicked. So let's do that again. Okay, so that's our input, and then you can see that I've altered this image with adding some fog. However, we have changed a little bit too much of the architecture. The higher we go in our noise value, the less of that base image is going to be kept. And in which case, especially for architecture, we can't just randomly change the building. We need to hold on to the site as the architect has designed it. So that is not going to work for us. The way we get around that is with control net. And I go through a lot of control net and how we use it in my tutorial series that I sell on my website, halletvisual.com. And if you want to see those results. This is, I think we still have Free You turned on. No, we don't. No. Okay, thanks so much for watching. If you want to like and subscribe, that's cool. I don't really care. I'm not trying to be a YouTuber. I'm an architectural renderer, and I also provide some tutorials on my website. If you're interested in learning more about stable diffusion in your architecture workflow, you can check that out. The link's below, halletvisual.com, and you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I'm usually on Facebook. That's where I post a lot of my work. So thanks for watching. Have a great day.